Hello everyone, welcome to the cloud network. In this video, I'm going to show you how to install your K1215.04 favorite player on the desktop. This one, and this is 64-bit supported. I'm going to show you on installing this virtual box. You can also install in VMware workstation also. The same method, the same procedure you need to follow, that I'm going to show you every step and every command you can find below to my video in the description box. My website is www.cloudnetwork.in, where this is a website where you can find all my tutorials, tips and tricks, troubleshoots about Windows servers, Mac OS, Macintosh and Linux, Fedora, all these flavors, Red Hat Linux also you can find in this tutorial. So let us begin. First of all, this Kubuntu support only for 9 months. It's 15.04. since all are supported for the desktop, server and the core. So these are supported for only 9 months. So what are minimum requirement you need to have? First of all is 1 GB processor or dual core processor you can have, and the 1 GB of RAM you need to have, and 6 GB of disk space you can have. And also display you need to have 10576. And you can install with this DVD or USB. USB you need to have 4 GB above, and DVD you need to have 4 GB. You need to make both of DVD and USB bootable. After that you can insert it and you can install with it also. Just inside the BIOS device, after that you can install it. And you need to have last one, internet access. So let us begin. So my friend, this is open your browser and type Kubuntu. So this is the website of Kubuntu, www.kubuntu.org. Click on the download link, it will be redirected to come here on the page you can see on the screen. So this one you can download for the 14.0 supported, and this one is your 15.0 latest one scheme. So just for the download, whichever you require download, click on this link and you will be scrolled down for the download. So you can see for this 32-bit supported and 64-bit supported. So you go for the 64-bit, or you can go have it 32-bit. Both are the 1 GB file of service will show you, and you can download from this torrent or mirror is there. And if you want to upgrade, there is a method to, you can upgrade also is there. You download the BitTorrent also is there, from the BitTorrent support is. If you want to burn in DVD or creating USB solution, this is also a method shown. So let us begin now for the installation. Now you can find watch us my how to install virtual box, how to download in my tutorial. You will find how to install virtual box. So I will be giving the link also, you can find the description box also in the video. You will find how to install virtual box. So let us begin. First of all, installing this Kubuntu. Open your virtual box and just you need to click on new. There you need to type here Kubuntu 15.04 64-bit desktop. Okay, after giving the name, select your version which you have downloaded, 32-bit or 64-bit. After selecting, click on next, and then you have to click on next. This is the hard disk which I am giving, at least 20 GB, and this is the location which is going to store it. So now after that, so now click on create now, and then you need to go to settings, where you need to define your ISO image and some internet drives. So click on setting, you can press control or also shortcut command, and you need to click on system, uncheck the floppy like this one. Okay, uncheck the floppy, and then go to this your RAM, assign the maximums at your green point. Okay, do not go to this red point. Go to enable the APA TPA, check this one box, and check this VDX and AMD enable. Then go to this storage, click on empty, click on the small CD icon where you find you need to define your ISO image where you have downloaded. So so my friend, you can see this is my K1215.04 desktop which ISO image I have downloaded. And click OK, go to network and assign your bridge adapter, click on OK, and then go for the start now. Now it's coming booting. So you can see on screen K1215.04 is booting. So my friend, on your screen you can see the default the screen saver is there. That wallpaper is showing very beautiful, this one. And you can see on the welcome screen, this Ubuntu 15.0 installation process is there. Either you can try the Kubuntu without the installation. If you do not want to install, just want to test the Kubuntu without installation, you can check this one by clicking. If you want to quit, you can quit here also. And for the installation, click on to install now. And so here is there. If you want to check the third party software installation, you can check. And if any downloads update are there by installation, it's also update, so it's update. So this requirement is already check mark is there. If it is and cross mark is showing, means you need to check back and then you need to come back. So next, you need to click on next. So here is showing where you like to install the Kubuntu on your entire disk. That means if you have a two hard disk, means you need to select the first hard disk which you want to install, or if I have one hard disk, if you want to have only this partition, means you can select the given the manual partition, you can set that. So use NVSATM or any character, whichever you want. I am going to keep entire disk. So before formatting, you should take a backup of your data and then go ahead. So please remember, before formatting this installing Kubuntu, you need to take a backup of your data. So if you want to go for the manual installation, click on this manual installation and go proceed. So you need to assign every partition as a manual. I'm going to click install now. After that, yeah, if it is something not to changes, you can go back and do two partitions have been created, extension 4 and the swap. This partition has been created and I'm going to click continue here. Now we need to select the time zone, then keyboard. We need to assign the user information. So it's create extension for file system and the partition is showing. Copy the files. So till this version can copy in the files, select the time zone from where you are belongs to. By clicking your region, you can select by default selected. At the clock and continue. I am going to check the keyboard here also. That means keyboard language we need to select here. The next option will be. Now we came to the keyboard layer language. You can select your which country it belongs to, and the blue is the image of the current keyboard shown. Okay, and this if you select different language, it will show you different language here. Click to continue and I am to give you a username. That means I am giving your name. That means I am giving full name here. No space I am giving here. Pick up the user, that I am giving the password. I am giving you a weak password. You need to give a strong password. Please remember the password and repeat the same password. I am giving you this one. You just give any name instead of cloud network. So require my password to login, or automatically I am going to check the password doesn't out next time when you boot reboot. It will not as a password directly it will be. Now here will installation started. So now it will take almost here 25 minutes. Till then you can have a coffee or tea, then back to you will show you the welcome to this Kubuntu image. Please stay. So my friends, that has been installed completed. You need to click on restart now. After clicking on restart, check the Kubuntu. So my friend, this is your welcome to the Kubuntu there. So you can see the time showing. This is your network connection to be detected. This is your sound showing. This is your menu Kubuntu. You click on the Kubuntu menu and see how it's showing the beautiful menu showing and application you can access here. Utilities, search bar also the command is running the my computer, that means that is going to shut down, restart, sleep mode, that is a beautiful menu. This is also some new things you have been showing how to show dashboard, showing add widgets. So these are the features that has been added in Kubuntu. Wow, it's very beautiful. Now how to make a full screen, just click on device and to click on insert case edition disk. When you need to click and install this one, so how you can install this one, you need to click double click on this one to have this run. Click on this one. Yeah, it's running, opening. So okay, double click. I need to install this one. So okay. Yeah, here we can. Right. So this is the method how you can make a full screen command. So something you should like it. Method we can make a full screen. Let's check the screen. friends, thank you for watching my video. For any clarification, you can comment on my video. Like and send my videos on my friends and friends. So I just to spread my channel. Thank you for watching.